the favor of God fall upon your people. Lord Jesus, arrest all satanic projection, various tatters, arrows, and witchcraft activities in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare favor over your life in the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus Christ, arrest all satanic projection, various tatters, arrows, and witchcraft activities in the name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare favor, favor of God. I pray that let favor of God, the favor of God, divine favor of God, let the favor of God come upon your enemies permanently. That is deny access to your life and destinies. The favor of God will take and maintain your position seated in heavenly places, and the devil is under your feet. You walk in dominion, power, and God's prophetic purpose now in the name of Jesus. As I declare to you favor, the favor of God to come upon your enemies permanent, that is denying access, that is denying elbow, that is denying you good things. The favor of God will take and maintain your position seated in heavenly places, and the devil is under your feet. You walk in dominion, power, and God's protection of God's prophetic purpose in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will lead you in the name of Jesus. You will receive favor. I declare the favor of God, that what was written of you in the volume of the books, your prophetic destinies and purpose will be fulfilled, and without delay and interference. I declare that the divine timing, strategy, relationships, open doors, favor in high places shall manifest continually in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you, Father. I declare favor. Let favor. Yes, my friend DJ, thank you. I declare favor on you. Let the favor of God fall upon everyone in Periscope. Everyone that is listening this prayer, I declare the favor of God, that what was written on you in the volume of the books, your prophetic destinies and purpose will be fulfilled now without delay or interference. I declare that divine timing, strategic relationship, open doors, and favor in highly places shall manifest continually in your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray, receive favor of God. Receive the favor of God. Receive the favor of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive favor. Let the favor of God, let the divine favor of God fall upon your situation for every problem in your life to manifest. I command every satanic mysterious circle in the name of Jesus Christ destroyed through the blood of Jesus. I plead the favor of God. Let the divine favor of God fall upon your situation for every problem in your life to manifest. I command every satanic mysterious circle and the mechanism to be permanently exposed, decoded, and destroyed through the blood of Jesus. My God, you are a wonderful God. I thank you, Father, for your favor. Lord, my God, let the divine favor of God fall upon every authority, detail, laws, church member, judgment, issues against you in the realm of the spirit be overthrown. I command injunction and restraining order be issued and enforcement against all acts of injustice and harassment in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I bless your name. I thank you, my God. Thank you, O God, my Father. I pray, let the divine favor of God fall upon every authority delay, every authority that is delaying you, every authority and law and judgment issues against you in the realm of the spirit be overthrown in the name of Jesus, my God and my Father. I pray favor of God to fall upon your finances, your finances. Yes, I pray, let the favor of God fall upon you this during this summer time. You need the favor of financial breakthrough. You need the financial breakthrough. Let favor fall upon your bank, your ATM, your credit card, your bank book, your checks in the mighty name of Jesus. You need the favor of God to fall upon your finances in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let the favor of God fall upon you and it will overtake you and flow in the name of Jesus. Yes, I'm declaring favor. I'm prophetically declaring favor of God to fall upon you. Your work is to say amen, big amen, in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I declare that God will rule in your favor and the divine order for your restoration and the restitution shall be signed with the blood of Jesus, with the blood of the Lamb and the enforcement by the angels of God on every level. Your victory shall be published throughout heaven, on earth and underneath the earth, and all shame and reproach shall be washed away, and you will receive double honor in the name of Jesus. You will receive double honor in the name of Jesus. I declare in the name of Jesus, I declare divine favor, that God will rule in your favor, and the divine order of your restoration and restitution shall be signed with the blood of the Lamb and enforced by the angels of God on every level. Your victory shall be published throughout heaven, on earth and underneath the earth. All shame and reproach shall be washed away, and you will receive double honor. You will receive double honor. Receive double honor. Receive double honor in the mighty name of Jesus. I, Father God, in the name of Jesus, I declare the favor of God fall upon you to overcome the enemy by the blood of the Lamb and the word of your testimony. Jesus saved you from the laws of sin and death. Therefore, you are active by the blood of Jesus to speak innocent for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and silence every accusation wherever it is, true or false, in the mighty name of Jesus, to locate and arrest and bind every power operating behind the scenes. Revelation 12 verse 11, the Bible says that you have the testimony, your testimony by the Lamb, by the blood of Jesus. My God and my Father, I pray that God Almighty, let the favor of God fall, let the favor of God come upon you. Let the favor of God come upon you in the name of Jesus. I declare and decree by the power in the blood of Jesus. I pray, let the favor of God come upon you. Every strong man operating in your lives to be stripped of the authority and assignment concerning you and your families. Lord Jesus, bind all weapons of Satan and destroy them. Let the group ground troops of Satan, persons without body and human vessels, to be captured, stripped of their power, and be permanently disorganized in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray and declare by the power in the blood of Jesus, I pray that let the favor of God come upon, let the favor of God come upon every strong man operating in your lives to be stripped of their authority and assignments concerning you and your families. Lord Jesus, bind all weapons of Satan and destroy them. Let the ground troops of Satan, persons without bodies and human vessels, be captured and stripped of their powers and permanently disorganized in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we bless your name. Lord, I bless you, God. I give you all the glory, Jesus. My God and my Father, I bless your name. Let the favor of God overthrow the wisdom tables of the wicked and scatter them wherever and whether upon their headquarters, and destroy all the weapons and means of restoration. Jesus, take territory by the power of the Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. Lord, my God. Lord, I decree and declare by the power in the blood of Jesus, let the favor of God overthrow the wisdom tables of wicked and scatter them wherever and wherever they gathered Lord Jesus, release weapons of mass of destruction upon their headquarters and destroy all their weapons and means of restoration. Jesus, take their territory by the power of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray, God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost fire, enter into the life of the enemies, enter into the power in the powers of darkness and destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. Favor of God, let the favor of God go to my enemies and destroy them. Let the favor of God fall upon the enemies that is attacking the work of God, that is using the weapon that it does not function. Lord, my Father, every weapon of the enemy that will not be functioning against our life in the name of Jesus, let their weapon be destroyed and be bound in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, as I pray, my God, let the favor of God, destroy every weapon of the enemies. The favor of God, let it go to the pocket of the enemies and cut them and remove them and cut them into pieces in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, where they are keeping their weapon, where they are keeping their evil ways, Lord, let the favor go and destroy them. Favor of God, the favor would make the enemy kill themselves. When God favors you, he will do mysterious miracle against your enemies. Your enemy will bow down in the name of Jesus Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. I bless you, God. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. The favor of God, the divine favor of God. Let's look in the book of Proverbs 3, verse 3 to 4. Hallelujah. Thank you, sister. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. We don't have other gods. We have only one God, Jehovah God. We have the living God who is in heaven. We don't have two gods. We only have God. Our Lord Jesus Christ is the Son of God. We have our God, God of Abraham, God of Isaac and Jacob. That's God we worship. We don't have any other God. Let's look in the book of Proverbs 3. Proverbs 3. Hallelujah. If I broke you by mistake, I will bring you back. I will unlock you. Because sometimes when I try to rock somebody, I will find I locked somebody by mistake. Don't worry, I will check. After I finish, I will check and I will bring you back. I will unlock you. In case, don't think that I lock you. But if in case I lock anybody by mistake, I will unlock them back when I finish this. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes. Let's look at the book of Proverbs 3, verse 3 to 4. The Bible says, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible says, let not mercy and truth forsake thee, bind them about the neck, light them upon the table of the heart. So shalt thou find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and man. You see, the favor, God is teaching us that let not stand fast, loyal, committed, devoted, and dedicated love and faithfulness forsake you, bind them around your neck, light them on the table or in the tablet of your heart, so you will find favor and good success in the sight of man and God. When the favor of God fall upon you, the favor of God will fall upon you to God and to man. This is what the Bible says. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee, bind them. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about the neck. Write them upon the table of the heart. So shalt thou find a good understanding in the sight of God and man. So the favor of God will fall upon you when you have mercy. Don't let the mercy of God depart from you. The masses, you have, when you have the mercy, then this mercy, God will use them. You know, the favor of God will not come to you if you are arrogant, if you are evil, if you don't have mercy, if you are not forgiving people. The favor of God will not come upon you. The favor of God will come to you when you are righteous, when you are doing the right thing. If you are not doing the right thing, there is no favor of God will come. That's why the Bible is telling us that let no mercy and the truth forsake thee. Let no mercy and the truth be moved from you. You know the truth of God. The truth will set you free. The Bible says, bind them about the neck. Write them upon the table of the heart. So write them. Don't let mercy and the truth of God to depart from you, to leave you. The Bible says in the book of Samuel 16, verse 7 to 13, if you see how favor works, the favor can go and look for you when you have been rejected, when nothing is happening to you. But the Lord will look for you when the favor of God fall upon you. The favor of God, it can look for you wherever you are. When you look at the book of 1 Samuel 16, 7 and 13, the Bible says, but the Lord said to Samuel, do not look on his appearance or on the height of his stature, because I have rejected him. For the Lord sees not as a man sees. A man looks on the outward appearance, but the Lord looks on the heart. Then just call Abinadab and made him pass before Samuel. And they said, neither has the Lord chosen this one. Then just made Shammah pass by. And they said, neither has the Lord chosen this one. And just made seven of his sons pass before Samuel. And Samuel said to Jesse, the Lord has not chosen this. Then Samuel said to Jesse, are all your sons here? And they said, there is remains yet the youngest, but behold, is keeping the sheep. And Samuel said to Jesse, send and get him, for we will not sit down until he comes here. You know, the favor of God went and looked to the boy called David, where he was keeping the sheep. He was looking the sheep of his father. And the favor of God go and look in where he was. So the favor of God will chase you. The favor of God will come and chase you wherever you are. You might be like now, Samuel wanted his son, the other sons who were with him, to be given the favor. But the favor was not for them. The favor was meant for David. So when the favor is meant for you, no powers of darkness will take it. No evil shall take your favor. No enemy will take your favor. So now, if as according to the word of God, Samuel tried, Jesse tried to show Samuel all his giant boys, all big boys. They were tall and appearance looks good. They were handsome boys there. But God says, no, I need that little young man called David. David was short and young. He was just a boy. He was a young boy. And these elder brothers, God rejected them. So when the favor of God comes, it doesn't matter which size you are, how you look like, whether you are beautiful, whether you are angry, whether you go to school, whether you didn't go to school. When the favor of God will fall upon you, it will look for you and it will come to you. Let the favor of God fall upon you and it will change your circumstances around you. Give me hearts. I need hearts. Yes, thank you so much. I need hearts. Give me hearts. Yes, I know you are listening. Thank you very much. Please give me hearts so that I can preach God. Thank you so much. Let's look at the favor. What the favor do. Yes. Consider Ruth. Her husband had died. The land was in Sophia famine. And she and her mother-in-law, Naomi, they did not have any food. They were particularly starving to death. Ruth went out to the fields every day and followed behind the harvest, picking up whatever leftover grain they had missed. And the Bible indicates that in the midst of that diversity, Ruth found favor with the owner of the field. That owner told his workers to leave handfuls of grain on purpose for Ruth. Note again that the help of God came during the crisis. Before long, Ruth and Naomi, his circumstances turned around and they needed were surprised in abundance. So the favor will come upon you. You, no matter what situation you are facing, no matter what you are right now, look at these women. They were widows and the poor. They didn't have nothing. They were starving to death, but the favor fell upon them. God favored them. God favored Naomi and Ruth. The favor of God, that God will favor you. Today, the Lord will bring favor. You might be in a corner. You might be in a situation where you've been worrying, you have been thinking, what can I do? But the favor of God is coming to you, and they change your circumstances around. The help of God is coming to you in the name of Jesus. I'm talking to you, the favor is on the way. The favor of God will come upon you as it came to these two women. They were widows and poor. They didn't know what to do. They were starving to death, but the favor fell upon them. And their life changed completely. Therefore, I prophesy to you, the Lord will visit you in a special way. Your situation will change in the name of Jesus Christ. You will receive favor. You will receive the money that you have never seen. Your job is coming in the name of Jesus. The Lord has opened windows of heaven to pour out blessings to you. Receive the favor of God. Your finances is going to change in the name of Jesus. Your job is going to change. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. You are the one to be healed in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. I thank God for you. I thank God for your life. God bless you so much. If you can look the favor, out the favor of God, even went to prison where Joseph was being locked, and the favor picked Joseph, and Joseph is within 24 hours, Joseph changed his circumstances. Joseph became a prime minister in Egypt. The favor will fall upon you, and your circumstances will change like a twinkling of eyes. When the favor of God will come, people will be asking, is that so and so we used to see? Is that so and so we used? They will be looking and shaking their head, and they will remain like that. Thank you so much. Thank you, my sister. Thank you. Thank you. My God, I thank you that the favor of God will change circumstances. Yes, my God. Thank you, my sister. Thank you so much. Thank you. Hallelujah. When the favor of God followed you, when the favor of God fall upon you, your life will not be the same again. You need the favor of God. You need the favor. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Look at that. Joseph is another example. It's another biblical example of someone who found the help of God is in adversity. In the midst of your adversity, in the midst of trouble, in the midst where you have no return, that is when the favor of God will show. That's when the help of God will show. Here is the situation where in the midst of your adversity, in the midst of your problem, but remember the favor of God. God will come and help you. The favor of God will come. The Bible says the help of God was upon Joseph. No matter what other people did to him, no matter where they put him, he continued to prosper. Even when injustice, being accused, rape, and he was thrown in prison, he continued to thrive. The help eventually caused him to be released. He was accused falsely. He was accused raping a woman, which he didn't. That's why the favor of God is awesome. This man was thrown in prison, accused falsely. He did not commit any offense. He did not commit anything. But a woman decided to lie, say that he has raped her. But that was a lie. But God, who knows the secret, who knows the truth, went and saw the favor in prison. And Joseph became a prime minister. And all his enemies, including his own brothers, God was with Joseph. And his brothers, when the famine struck their country, God made Joseph, these brothers, to bow down as he had a dream. So the favor will make you, your enemies, to come and bow down, to kneel and bow down before you. Your enemies that are laughing you at you, that are mocking you, God will make them to come and kneel before you. The Lord Almighty is awesome God. I want to tell you as a testimony. I was working in the factory when I came to this country. You know, you get anything to do. When I went to work there, a supervisor became very arrogant. She didn't like me. And she didn't like me, so she told me, don't come back. So I said, thank you. I went back to the office. I said, they have said, I don't know what I did to them, but God is good. At the office, I was hired there. I was hired as a consultant in that office where the supervisor who didn't like me, now the supervisor was under me. You see, when she heard that I am now working in the office administration, this supervisor, I made her to come to the office to see me, to see my office. And when she came and found me, she could not say anything. She did say anything, and I make sure that I will deal with her accordingly. So I told her, now I had to show her that God that I serve is a living God. She did me evil, but God promoted me. You see, that is how it is. The enemy would make sure that you are suffering. They have fixed you a place. They are waiting for you to die or to be destroyed. But the favor of God will come in the midst of adversity. The favor of God will come and find you. Wicked people, they do so wickedly to other people. Yeah? A friend, the best maid. The best maid. A man who was a best maid of the wedding, of their wedding. After the wedding, this man, best man of a man, after the wedding, because this wife, the woman, this is the best man of the man. So he didn't know that this man would be changing his ways. So the man trusted this best man to his wife. And now this man went to talk to this wife, and the wife, they did something, they end up in bed, they end up sleeping with this best man of this man. And then this man discovered that the best man has slept with his wife. They have just wedded, they are newly wedded. You can see the wicked. And then this man said, my God, he cried, he could not believe what this best man has done to his wife. And the wife said, I don't know why I did that, forgive me. But the man, because he was so upset and offended, then he divorced the wife. After divorcing, they went and married. They went, the best man married this woman. They married and they wedded. After a few months, this best man died, and the man who was the first man for this man went and married another woman, and they prosper, they moved to America. Then this woman, she was living miserable and crying. You see, that is how the enemy would make you to suffer, but in the return, when the favor of God will change your circumstances. Because this woman, it is her power to refuse the best man of the man to come and have affairs with her. But she decided to sleep with her. And because of that, God killed that man. That man died because of his, whether it is God or the devil, but the man died and that woman remained widow. And the man, he has disgraced, he went and got another woman and married and live in good life. You see, that is how it is. When the favor of God fall upon you, no matter what it is, the God of Elijah, the Lord of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob will visit you in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father. We give you all the glory, Jesus. Lord, we honor you, God. We thank you, my Father. I want to stop here. I pray that God Almighty will deliver you, will deliver you from the hands of your enemies. The favor of God will fall upon you. My God and my Father, I pray for your people, God. Let your favor fall upon them. Everybody that is going through something, Lord, my Father, let your favor fall upon them. In the midst of their adversity, your favor will fall upon them, God. I pray the power of Holy Ghost, the power of God, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let your favor fall upon them, God. Receive the favor of God. Receive the favor. Let the favor of God go and disgrace your enemy and destroy every enemy that is working against you. Every agent of the devil, every agent of Satan, let the favor of God fall upon them and destroy them and rob them in Jesus' name. My Father, I want to thank you for your people. I want to give you the glory, God, my Father. Your people need favor, God. Let your favor fall upon them, my God. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. Right now, yes. Right now, Jesus, my God, look at your people, my Father. Let your favor, the favor which followed Joseph, the favor which followed Naomi and Ruth, let it fall upon them, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We have so many examples. Even Esther, that favor, Esther was an oven, but the favor went and looked for her, and Esther was favored. You will be Esther. You will be Joseph. You can be Joseph. You can be Esther. Let the favor of God fall upon you, like the favor of Esther, like the favor of Joseph, in the mighty name of Jesus, like the favor of David. That favor that went and looked for them, they did not go to look for the favor. You know, there's people who are looking for favor, but these people, they were no idea. Look at David, where I was. David was in the taking care of the sheep, but the favor went and looked for him. Joseph was in prison. He didn't know, but the favor went and looked for him. Esther, the same. Therefore, the favor of God will come to look for you. The favor of God will come and will fall upon you, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, Father, Lord, cover your people. Let the favor flow upon them. Let the favor enter in their children. Let the favor of God enter in their family. My God and my Father, I thank you. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. See you tonight. See you tonight, midnight, 12 midnight. God bless you. I love you so much. Remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. You can also call us. You can call us. Our number 877-241-3420, extension 101. Or you can reach me, our cell phone. We are on Skype. We are on WhatsApp. We are on the media, so just call me from any media. Especially Skype, I found it's working very well from Arab country. And you can call me on Skype, Overcomers 777-777-333. Skype. You can also reach us in email. Email Overcomers dhm@gmail.com. You can reach us, Overcomers, dhm@gmail.com. Our phone number, the cell phone, 647-608-5207. The cell phone, 647-608-5207. If you are calling from another country, you have to add +1 or 001. So, thank you very much. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful time. See you another time. I love you so much, and there's nothing I can do about it. Love you. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye-bye.